I think the place where the private sector can really excel is this notion of long-term performance-based outcomes. Whether it's resiliency and the threat of rising rivers or rising sea levels, what investment you're making today has got to be able to survive. Literally, it's to make sure there's no holes in the dike that you built, right, over the next 30 years. Private sector, much, much better at asset management over the long term, about ensuring that there's performance-based outcomes. Those are the places where I think government ought to be encouraging the private sector to say, come in here and do that. Are we going to be converting a bus system to battery electric buses? Well, that's a much bigger risk now with respect to servicing the kinds of populations that Kelly was just describing. If the electric grid goes out, it's not just a diesel engine breaking down and therefore someone missing their buses, all buses will go down in that system and therefore depriving people of the ability to get to work. Having the private sector and their discipline around performance-based outcome and long-term resiliency targeting is a place where government should welcome in the private sector for investments.